Hi.
Smells like that chicken in here.
It's big stick time, sweetie. One, two, three. Big stick. Great job.
Could you do it, Victoria? You can take blood from people? I bet you could.
Don't stop talking.
I'm trying to take your mind off of it.
You're not working.
28, that was bad.
It's just this starting all over again.
I know. Right, I don't want to get back to it. Right. And that was a fear of mine because she had had, even though November was bad, it was like she had had symptoms
for a while
before that. And so,
yeah.
You know, it was like, so that was my fear. Obviously, we don't want to be on steroids forever is the other thing. So that's what I wanted to kind of talk to y'all about today. What are our other options? Now, my concern is that because she had the symptoms for so long, we are going to deal with a chronic ITP picture. Usually, you'll do like... Usually they'll try it again. So we'll go up on the dose of the steroids, maybe not as high as we were because we know that she responded really well and she had a lot of side effects and I don't want to go through that again, but maybe doing like 10 milligrams every day for a couple weeks, getting that count back up and then bringing her back down kind of slowly like we did and seeing if we can maintain her and then try to come off at another point and then say at that point, okay, let's move forward with rituximab.
Disappointed because we didn't want her going to Birmingham with high school and college age friends to go shopping for the day.
We don't know what they are. This was a week ago from Lobenthal's office, so we just don't have you going because we thought, teenage boys, what are they going to do? And we said, you can't go with them.
You can't go with them in the first place.
Well.
Let's do that. Let's start the 10 milligrams. That'll give us a starting point today. How about I give you all some printout information about the rituximab?
This is probably like the worst looking quality thing I've ever put on YouTube, but I wanted to sit and talk for a minute because I literally have not talked all day. If you were listening, yes, I am starting steroids again. I don't remember all that I said in my video about my blood disorder. If you only follow me on YouTube and nowhere else, basically 2 weeks after the infusion, my platelets dropped again. And then they started me on steroids, which gave me the worst summer of my life. I was tapered off of them, finally. And About a week and a half ago, I noticed that my symptoms were coming back, and I had literally just quit the steroids. And I don't know, you guys might have noticed it before I did, but this bruise that was appearing, it literally was not there last night. And I saw it today when I was sitting in the waiting room. And you guys might have seen it earlier when I was doing my makeup. I saw it when I was watching it back, but it really was not there last night. So my gums and my mouth is just bleeding. They used to just bleed when I would brush my teeth. They just sort of, my mouth would just bleed. I literally ate ice cream one day and there's just blood all over my ice cream. So the symptoms have gotten kind of worse. I don't want to talk about this a lot, because I have had a lot of people say that I'm just doing it for attention and I'm taking advantage of it and trying to get people to feel sorry for me, when I'm not. I talked about it a lot at first because it was new to me. It was a big change in my life, and now it's become more normal. So regardless of the people who say that I do this for attention, I just want to keep you guys updated. I'm trying not to talk about it so much because I know it can get annoying. I don't want to hear the same thing from people 24/7 either. And now that this has become a pretty normal part of my life, I don't feel the need to talk about it all the time. I don't need to post on Snapchat every single time I go get my blood taken. I'm just getting my blood taken. That's normal now. At first I was holy crap, I get my blood taken every week. That's crazy. And now it's that's normal. It's normal to go to the doctor every single week now. It was my entire summer. Literally from March until now, it's been my life, so I'm used to it. And I don't really know what the point of this video was. I just kind of felt like making it. So yeah, we had kind of sort of a get ready with me this morning. So now let's get unready with me.
Nobody's left.